I don't want to hear it. Yo, did you feel me? Got the Dita hat on, little dad hat. I get it, you feel me? A little, I'm rocking it a bit though. You feel me? With the black jacket. But anyways, you feel me? We got Mira in the bed. And we got Andre in the bed. You put the Dewey on. You feel me? No ways. Dewey no ways. Damn, they can run that shit. Dewey no ways. Hold on. Hold on, yeah, let me check that. Come on, yeah. Come on, nigga. Wait, I gotta see the top, nigga, what the fuck? Okay, they good. Nigga, you need the 360s, bro. You need the 360s, bro. The top waves is basic. Bro, you can get anybody get the top waves, bro. That nigga with the flat top get the top waves, bro. That shit gonna be clean. I already got a sound, but he's slipping. He just got his right, that right side. I mean, I was like that too. My right front corner though. I had a lot of like forks right there and shit. But man, anyways, y'all, shit. We chill out. We finna go get some pizza, cause it's the hot girl birthday. You feel me? Whoa! You feel me? The hot girl birthday. You feel me? Say birthday. You feel me? You feel me? All that. So, you know, we gonna make the best of it. You know, I'm here. Y'all know me. I don't wanna go out like that. It's unless it's with people I really fuck with. You feel me? And connect with. So, if I it's simple. It's that. I always like try to get a good energy, all that positive energy, all that, cause. Why not, my nigga? You feel me? So, you never know. You never know when you might get on. You feel me? So, all that. Always show love, bro. You never know. Anyways, I catch y'all. I see.
Yo, what's good with y'all niggas? You feel me? Bigger on a bit. All that. Anyways, so I'm about to go in the beauty supply store. You know, give me some more hair ties. And, I was gonna get a sponge. So, I could. Cause I've been sponging my shit lately. Yeah, I still might get it, depending on how I'm feeling. Cause I'm gonna have my mom braid my hair today too. So I was like, if she braids my hair, cause I know when she braids my hair, I usually leave them in like for a long time. And actually, no, she told me to get this Jamaican wax too, so it can hold. So I might not even need the sponge. Or I might just get that later on. Yeah, then I gotta get this car washed. Yeah, dual times. I gotta get car washed back in and out. You know, simple shit, you know, not nothing big. We know. You know me, I just be chilling, you know, all that. So, yeah, I catch y'all when I see y'all. Got the shit. Yeah. Make my shit smell good. Ooh. No advertising. This shit smell good though. Good. I'm for the girl. Let my hair grow out, cause nigga, my fucking hair, nigga. I need to go to a barber shop, nigga. I'm not even gonna lie to you. Hold on. It's my turn to get in.
I'm gonna let all this shit grow. And then right into the barber. For a month, you feel me, for my birthday, I'm gonna get a cut. But for my birthday, bro, you feel me? So, yeah. Anyways, I'm gonna listen to some music. Catch y'all.
Yo. First of all, let me look for that soda. Hold on, yo. I done dropped my motherfucking soda.
That motherfucker go up. That shit gonna spray off. Hopefully, you know, nigga shit. Oh, no. Oh no. Anyways. So I made some tacos. You did. Slight mukbang shit. With the whole girl. You feel me? My baby moms. I'm just playing. Nigga. No nigga be taking shit out of proportion, nigga. So yeah, I was like, man, I was making some tacos. And shit. I'ma actually explain when shit get here. How this whole thing started, how we even got to like link it up to making this mukbang for me, because it's not that big of a deal, but it wasn't like no random, oh, hit her up and I said let's do mukbang, you feel me? It wasn't like that. Anyways, I don't know about her,
But I'm gonna get started on my shit though. Fuck all the bullshit. You did. Anyways. That motherfucking fire, baby. Ooh, that been fire, baby. That been fire. I got the Durag on. Cause look who decided to. I had to eat something cause I was like kind of. Oh, yeah. So they had a deal $2 for $3. So I was like, fuck it, let me do this. So bad. Anyways, now that she here, I can finally explain how we. So pretty much, I butt dialed her, you feel me?
Oh.
And all that. While I was making the tacos, that shit scared me. Look, all that. I had the phone in my pocket with that. I took the phone out of my pocket. I looked at my screen. All I see is her looking at me. And I'm like, what
and
the
fuck? And I started dying laughing. It's like, oh shit, I thought I was on your story. Shit.
Nigga, I'm like, what the fuck? I thought I was watching, like, nigga, I don't remember being on her story, nigga. I don't remember, like, you feel me? But then I'm like, oh shit. And then I'm like, better, because I know she kept telling me to, like, whenever I like cook something, I'll post it, send it to my streets. And so she was like, oh, like, you know, like next time. I'm like, next time when I'm making something.
Oh, yeah. He's like, I got you. Because yeah. I was joking. I was like, oh, so you going to slide something? He's like, what? He's like, oh, when I was cooking, he's like, okay, for sure. I was like, oh, I was just kidding, but thank you. And then he brought me some tacos. I was like, hey. But no, what I think what happened was I had just texted him about something that was on the story. And then when he exited out and put it in his pocket, it didn't exit all the way out. So it ended up clicking the little call button because it's like right next to the slide out button. And I'm like, I answer. I'm like, what the fuck? Because it was just ringing. I was like, okay, he must actually be trying to call me. So I answer and it's like pitch black. I'm just sitting there like, just looking at the camera because it's
like
dark.
I feel like the universe wanted us to make this mukbang. For real.
I was sitting there like, and I just sat there like, I'm going to see how long before he looks at his phone. I'm like, hey. Hey, yo, look at your phone.
And my phone be on do not disturb, so I ain't gonna know text message or nothing. I didn't hear none of that shit.
And then I'm like, I'm trying not to make it too loud because I don't want his mom to be like, what the hell? Because I can hear her in the background too.
Damn,
so really? Yes, I can hear everything. I heard the tacos on Tuesday, Wednesday. Mm. I heard the chicken. I heard everything. I heard the menus. I heard what needed to be bought from the store. Mom, did you buy the cheese? What cheese? What? Oh no,
oh, I bought the other thing. That's why I started humming.
Yeah.
I was like, oh my god.
And he just started. He goes.
I just started
humming, and I'm like, how long is he? And it took literally almost 15 minutes. It was like, it said 14:38 or 39 when he looked. I started hearing the phone move. I said, okay, maybe he's about to. He pulls it up. He's like, the fuck?
Nigga, what the hell?
That's I was like, nigga. Me. He was like, yo.
That shit was crazy.
He's like, what happened? I'm like, I think you phoned out. Like, you butt dialed me in your pocket. Like, I don't know how to. And he was like, oh, damn. I'm like, yo. That shit was funny. That was like never happened to me.
But yeah, and then I was like, you know, I was making it. I was like, might as well shit. Mom's here, might as well make some tacos for you. And that shit, you know, I'm making the tacos. I'm like,
fuck, I forgot to bring down the sour cream.
This girl. You gotta get it. You ain't tripping.
Do you want some sour cream or you about to be done?
Like, no, I got some sour cream.
You already got one?
Yeah, I will mess it up. You did? Yeah. So I had one thing. Let me see. Chris Wallace, this is fire, I ain't gonna lie. But anyways. And then, nigga, when I was, put it up. Nigga, when I was coming out the gas station from the stove getting some soda, I'm about to turn on, right? Man, this car, I swear, this car was like by the light. So I'm on Atlantic and Santa Fe, right? So, you know, if y'all niggas, you know, on Santa Fe, it's that Arco gas station right there, right across the street from, what's over here? Starbucks, you feel me? So it's a car by the light. He not even like close near nowhere near me, you feel me? Like he like I have time to pull out. This nigga gonna blink his light, right? He see me turn out, he gonna blink his light. And I'm like, nigga, what the fuck? You want me to wait for you? And you, cause you speeding? Nigga, you better slow your ass down, nigga. What the fuck? You tripping, nigga. You tripping, nigga. If you think I'm finna just wait for your ass and you not even, I got time to turn. I got time, bro. You feel me? I got time. And she going over here. Flip. Nigga, shit. Got me fucked up. So I went. She went, I'm like, bitch, you gonna honk at me, nigga? You should slow down or turn in the next lane. Bro, I swear, it was no cars, like, no cars at all. It was just that car, right? It was just her, bro, coming. She was just speeding. And then, like, nigga, what the fuck? You could easily just switch to the next lane or slow your ass down. Simple, my nigga. You feel me? Fuck you talking about? So, anyways, I'm like, shit. I'm over just cussing her out while I'm in the car. I was gonna hump back. I was tense. I was gonna... like, bitch, you honk at me, I'ma honk right back. Bitch, I got a horn too, what the fuck? You feel me? And then I just start speeding, like, nigga, what? Shit. You feel me? And I was like, man, fuck that shit, bro. I just started listening to music and shit like that. People, bro. People be shit. Bro. Like, hey, man, say, man. See, I want to wait. See, me, I eat fast. I want to wait. I'm going to wait. Because then, if I'm done, it's going to be done. I'm just going to be right here looking at you. So, no. I'm going to wait.
Give me Angie. Back in Angie.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Anyways, wait. First of all, before you start anything, how you been? Everything cool, everything solid. I ain't seen you in a minute. I ain't seen
her. Oh, God. Like, really. Like, it's been a while.
Since we, like, you feel me, really deep.
Yeah. Shit. You know, I'm just hanging in there because it's a lot of bullshit going on, but I just keep having to brush it off because it's like it's not much I can do.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just, you know, letting life happen until it's fixed. Mm-hmm. Shit. At this point, it's nothing.
Just doing what you're able to do.
Right.
Simple. I feel on that. Well, rather than everything starting and shit, you know, mom's cool. Damn.
Yeah, no. Mom's not cool right now.
Damn, man. Well, it's worse. The same shit you told me last time. No,
some medical shit.
Mm.
Yeah.
You in the hospital right now? Or she...
No. She good right now, but they're like, we got to hurry up and get a move on the situation because they don't know how long she's going to be able to hold on for. But I'm
pray about it.
I know. God, that's all we've been doing, bro. Like, straight praying about it because this
shit
is crazy.
Everything you can control. Don't stress about it, bro.
But I'm like, it's just me and her. She's the last thing I need to lose, bro. She is only me and her.
I can't imagine how you're going to feel coming to me telling me how.
Especially right now, because we're still trying to figure out if there's a way for them to hurry up and put me on disability so I can have some type of income while they're trying to get me checked out and shit. And that's not moving any faster. So I got to try to get a psychiatrist because the therapist situation ain't working. So they want me to get a therapist and a psychiatrist. So if they have to put me on medicine or some shit or whatever, they can write it down legally as a disability and all this other shit. So,
anyways, I thought she'd check it.
Thank you, feel me?
Black honey, that shit cool.
You feel me? She got this from New York.
Oh, yeah?
She went out to New York, she came back, and she brought me this.
And she didn't take you over there, nigga?
Nigga, she went over there to go see a nigga.
She went, oh, wow.
He flew her out there and ended up being a bum-ass nigga about it. She ended up leaving him and going to go shopping with her homegirl.
So he was mad that he spent money on her to come to New York?
No, that's the thing. He didn't really spend money. His, stepbrother or something, or, like, brother-in-law or whatever, worked for the airport and gave him a voucher for a round-the-way ticket, so, like, a whole round trip. So, whenever you get there, a few weeks or whatever, and then leave. So, that was basically paid for. He was supposed to help pay for the Airbnb and all the extra shit in between. Did none of that shit. My mama came out her pocket for all that shit.
So she went to New York expecting he was gonna pay. That's the only that's one of the reasons why she also went. So
he told her, he's like, I want you to come out here and go shopping. I want to take you places, blah blah blah. And she was like, okay, you know. And she he had been saying this shit for some years now. Like, this dude had been wanting to see her for some years now. Like, they, you know, they only really FaceTimed, but she had met him before. It's just that they only really FaceTimed. They just hadn't seen each other in, like, years. So he's like, yeah, come out here, blah, 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 and promising all this shit. And she kept telling him, like, if you really can't do it or really not going to do it, just don't say that, you know, because I'm already on my expenses as it is. Like, you can't just put me in that position. Soon as she got out here, this nigga.
What happened?
None of the stuff he said. And then he was doing pointless shit, like lying for no reason. Just, they be in the room and bro would like fart or something random. And she like, bro, are you fucking serious? Like, you couldn't have just got up. You just had to, you just couldn't got up. And like, you knew it was, yeah.
I don't know.
But this is the part that fucked her up. She said, are you fucking, what are you talking about? What the fuck you mean? I'm talking about? Bro, you just, I didn't fart. I don't know what you're talking about. That must have been you. And was dead ass serious about it. Not even a joke. She's like, quit playing. Like, there's only two of us in this motherfucker. Who the fuck? And I was like,
no, it's not me.
I'm on the phone dying laughing. And she's like, what the fuck? You know what? Goes to the kitchen to go get some of her Jameson because she had bought some liquor while she was out there. That shit almost gone. My mom's like, what the fuck? I bought that. And you're not going to replace it. The fuck? Then she didn't have no weed because you can't take it on the plane. So he went to go get her some weed, got her some like some shit, like it wasn't even like, and she was just like, what the fuck is it?
They weed on
something that was going, not even just that, it was just like, it was something that was gonna last her maybe that day. And she's like, I'm here for 2 weeks, the fuck is this gonna do? Like, sir. She's like, you know what? Fine. She just was mad that she had to come out of her pocket not knowing, because she was like, I was already planning on, you know, going shopping or whatever, spending a little money or whatever. But you don't tell me you're going to do that shit and then turn around and then, like, what the fuck?
Because I have, my mindset is me spending the money on what I know I'm going to spend on. Right. Not on the shit that's
And then going. If it needs, like, Airbnb, she was like, shit, I would, like, cover half. I covered the full fucking thing. He didn't even cover half. And then.
Wait, why he couldn't do none of, why he decided not to do that shit?
Wait. But then, not only that, he was talking about taking her to go places to see some shit, and he didn't. She was in the house for like 3 days before she lost it. She's like, bro, I'm going to leave. If you don't figure some shit out, I'm going to leave. He's like, all right, going to take her on a walk down to, like, I don't know if it was like from the Bronx or Brooklyn or some shit that was real grimy, but they were having to cross a bridge to get to the other side of wherever it was. This nigga going to go, it's all right, we just got to walk down this path. She said, nigga, that bridge? He's always just a path. The bridge. No, it's a path. She looks at a random person. Excuse me, is that a bridge? He's like, yes. That's a path on a bridge, right? He's like, yes. So, nigga, you're taking me across the fucking bridge. I started losing it. Like, what is not clicking here? What is not happening? And this nigga is just like, I mean, it's just. She was like, you know what? I'm done. She left. She literally packed up all her shit out the Airbnb, got a new Airbnb, and went to go see her homegirl for like 3 days. And he was like, you really left me?
Hell yeah, nigga.
What the fuck? Hell yeah, I did. I already told you what it was and what it is. And you, okay, thank you. And did not respond to his phone calls for like the next 3 days. Came back 2 days later and he was like, I get you some food and blah, 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 blah. She's like, so you spent, you know, about like $45 on a trip that I basically spent like $500 or more on. And he was just like, she's like, no, you can't even say sorry because we talked about this. If you do not have your financial stability together, if you don't have the shit you told me you had together while I got my shit together, the fuck did you think was gonna happen here? You can't touch me, you can't get up on me, none
of
that.
So he just said that just to
get her over there. And then was like, when you gonna marry me?
That nigga cold for that. That's some New York shit, man.
Nigga, you gonna say when you gonna marry me? I was like, woo.
And he dead ass too.
He still keep asking her when you gonna marry me. She's like, never. Never.
Oh, I was dead.
You in your 40s now and then you still live with your mother. Never.
In the 40s?
And still live with his mama. No. Hell no. My mama's like, his mama better than me. No. I would've kicked all them grown-ass men out.
No.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Hold on. Anyway, I can't let you go without you tasting this, because it got a little lime in it. It got a little lime.
Oh, you made it?
Bow. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Nigga, where was you? Nigga, how come you didn't do this shit earlier when I had a whole 2 tacos?
I asked you.
No, you didn't.
I said, do you want me to bring you
some? You didn't tell me that you made it. You didn't tell me that. I thought it was just regular sour cream.
Either way.
I had sour cream in my shit already. That's why. If you made it, I'm like, oh, hold on. That's some new shit. This girl.
You did. You know what? It's all right.
Bring it.
Next time.
Yeah. How the tacos taste on?
I'm only going to eat 2 because I want 2 more later.
Bad. You heard that, nigga? You heard that? Mm-hmm. And this is just some slice shit. You know, slice shit. I ain't gonna lie, my mom made the sauce. She made the sauce, so I didn't even know how she made it. But she made the sauce, and I just did everything else. You know what I mean? Shredded it.
I don't know.
All that. Anyways, my mom just braided my hair, too. She, hold on, let me take the doobie off. Wave check. But yeah. You feel me? It's all right. I'm just waiting for the.
A little slump.
You know, you smell that. You know what I mean? Gotta have them smelling right.
Right.
All that. Yes, sir.
Moisturize, you know.
Yes, sir. You got some. I forgot what it's called. It's some shit.
Not the castor oil?
I think that's what it was.
Cause castor oil is still Jamaican castor oil. They just never really say that. I mean, no. The Jamaican castor oil is darker. Regular castor oil is lighter. My bad.
It was dark.
Okay, then it was Jamaican castor oil. Or,
Probably. I don't know.
Because
I didn't even know that shit. So, castor oil is pretty much from Jamaican descent.
Yeah, but I'm saying, like, there's some that are more, like...
Lighter.
Yeah, they're, like, or heavier. You give me, like, thicker oil than the rest. Like, I have Jamaican castor oil upstairs, but it's the one with the lemon scent.
I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, it's from this natural grow place.
Yeah. I was in my room one day, and I was like, I should get the waves back. And I was like,
I don't know, you've been growing your hair for a while.
Because I was going to be like, all right, so I was trying to make excuses for myself. So I was like, no, I'm going to get the way and I'm going to restart. You feel me? That was my excuse to get the way. Like, I'm restarting. I'm not going to have them just to have them. I'm restarting. And then I was like, nah, Nate, what you said? Like, fuck all the bullshit. I didn't wait too long for my hair like this, and yeah, no, nigga, my shit too A1 for.
I totally feel you. Look, so my hair just grew back to where it was, and it's still growing, thank God, because I had to do a whole respark process, and it's in transition right now, so it's like different than what it used to be.
So you got 2 balls on your forehead too. Oh, that's a bow tie? Oh.
It's a scarf. I made it into a bow.
Okay.
I had it in, like, a big puff earlier. I mean, yeah, like, not too long ago, because when I had them in the 2 puffs way earlier, when I first walked my dog, them things were too damn tight, and my whole head was like, rrr. So I let it rest all day, and then I came outside, and the dude that lived over here was like, you don't like your hair in the puffs? I said, I had it earlier. That shit just hurt. And he started laughing, so I went inside the house, and I was like, I was like, let me redo it, because earlier I felt like it was too rushed and it just kind of pulled everything.
Mm-hmm.
But now it's fine. But yeah, that shit was hurting.
That shit looked like it kind of grew a little bit.
Hmm?
It looked like it kind of did grow.
It did. My afro was like out here now. It just shrunk because I added water. So it just kind of.
That's a set.
I just ain't been posting the natural videos because, yeah.
Because what?
I just ain't been. Like, I ain't really been posting. Plus, shit been
yeah.
weird. People are fucking weird.
What happened?
trying not to put my hands on people. I'm really trying not to put my hands on people.
What happened? Like not like, you know, just like not.
Nah,
details,
people like to call me out their name. You know, like they be like, oh, this bitch thinks she know everything. This bitch thinks she doing this. This bitch thinks she doing that. And I'm like,
that's
all right. Cause they're like, bitch, shut the fuck up. What's up? And I'm like, this is somebody I have known for years. And the only reason why they mad is because they know they were in the wrong and they felt like they were attacked or called out. But it's like, if you felt that way on some real...
That's probably what you're doing at. Because maybe some shit, I know a lot of stuff be done, I know some shit be like that, where people, you know, they'll say certain stuff and then you feel like you're attacked because you've been doing that. You feel me?
But that's what I'm saying. Don't be mad at me because you ain't on your job and you feel like you already know. You already know what the fuck you was doing, what you wasn't doing?
Exactly.
So I'm like,
When I made this, I didn't think of you in my head. I just did it because I just felt like saying
thank you.
You feel me?
And then my homie, I posted a thing about, like I said, a lot of the people that be wanting to link with me or that care about me, they don't really live too close to me. Like, I can't just walk to them. And if I can, they still kind of far. It'd be like a 10, 20-minute walk. They don't live just right next to me. They don't live close to me. A lot of the people that, like, I hang with, they can't just see me. Or when they try to, like, something, you know, comes up.
You ain't trying to bust that mission?
Huh?
You ain't trying to bust that mission?
What you mean?
You said 10, 20-minute walk.
Oh, no. I do. What I'm saying is, in general, they don't really just live close to me. And she and a few other people that felt attacked by it did used to live close to me.
Mm-hmm.
But they moved, but they're still like closer than most people. You get me? So I had posted about like how my close connection with certain people then fell off, and it hurts, not gonna lie. But you know shit happens.
Yeah.
And I was like, everybody that
especially really those cool, good, especially they play a good role in your life.
You're right. So I'm like, the people that have kind of, you know, they either were the closest thing I had to a sibling growing up after my sister passed, or they were just somebody that I was really, really close to. Like, we really grew up, like, our families know each other type shit. And basically, you know how I sent out that meditation link to everybody?
Oh, yeah, I did.
Yeah. Because, it has different ones. Yeah, it's one with breathing and this one for school and all that shit.
I be doing that shit.
Man, that's why I said I sent it to everybody, you know? And I get a text from her, and she's like, yo, don't fucking text me. I'm like,
so a problem.
Yo, what is wrong? Like, wow. And then all of a sudden she started talking
shit.
What
did I do?
Right. And I'm like, so instead of coming to me and talking to me, you want to be on some petty childish shit and going post in all caps with her eyes rolled back. Bitch, shut the fuck up. You think you know everything about everybody, but you fucking don't. Fuck. If it's really all you talking about shit and talking shit about people, what's up? Look. This person of all people should know that I'm the last person that she wants to fight. Because not only, one, does she bruise easily, but two, I know all her weak spots. And three, she has seen me swing a 6'3" nigga into a wall. She has had to drag me to my own therapist and my counselor, like, restraining me and could barely restrain me, like, to my damn therapist. While I'm hysterically fucking laughing, okay? Like, you're the last person to say that about me. And I said, you know what? She already knows what it is. I was like, you already know. Like, if you want, you know where the fuck I live. If you want, we
if
can
you
do
need
it.
That, let her pull up.
Nah, and what she do, just view all of my stories and never pulled up. I said, all right, that's what I'm fucking talking about. But she did. Did she block me? No. Did she? Did she? What? Did she? No. So I just left it alone. That shit just bothered me.
That's
why
I was
like,
LOL. If I just LOL.
That's why I was laughing. I was like, oh, this is the most somebody's posted about me. Oh my gosh, I feel loved. I feel loved. Like, that's all I could do is laugh. Because it's like, are you fucking serious?
I've known you for almost 6 years. I'm not talking about, like, I wouldn't be looking at their story, to be honest, because I know myself. I'll be mad. Like,
No. I only looked to see if she continued, but she only posted one thing. She just left it at that. And I was like, you know where the fuck I'm at? And all she did was just view all the stories. She never swiped up. She never. So I said, all right. And I left it at that. And I told everybody else, if anybody else got a problem, talk to me. Shit, we can really resolve it. If you want to be adults about it like you claim you are, if y'all want to be big wolfing it and, you know, oh, I'm this and I'm that, step like that then. Don't be on no childish petty shit. Don't be on no little punk shit. Like, don't do that. It just don't sit right with me. Because, you had, you know, plenty of opportunity to speak your mind on what the fuck the situation was. And if you feel like you were being attacked, just like I would normally be like, oh, was this about me? And she'd be like, oh, no, why the fuck would it be about you? You ain't even been around. I'd be like, whoa. Like, she used to say shit like that. And I'm like, okay.
That's why you shouldn't even use this line. Like, say,
no, I didn't. I just, I'd be like, oh, okay,
not
for
in
sure.
The first place. Huh? Like, in the first place, if you feel like you're being attacked by someone, then no, that means you
no,
need
but
to
see, that's on. The thing. I was being attacked. And I just asked. I didn't even come. I was like, are you okay? Did I do something? Or, like, did somebody do something? Nah, it's fucking good. Why would you fucking care right now? I was like, whoa. I was like, so, me?
Wait, so was you really being attacked? Like, she really
low key,
going
yeah,
for you?
She was. She was trying to, she was speaking to everybody, but she was speaking to me specifically. Like, and I know this because when she did it the first time, it was like right around her birthday. And when I said happy birthday and wrote her a little paragraph or whatever, she put THX, like, thanks. Like, just thanks. Like, no, like, oh, thanks. No emoji. No, just thanks. And when it came to my birthday, she put HBD. I was like,
that's it.
All right. And then when I tried to give her a present, I'm sorry, I don't want a present from you. Okay. And I left it at that. Because I already knew. Like, she'd been acting funny for the past 2 years. I can already see it. And she would blame
you
it on
what?
Me.
I think it's because you on a higher level than her.
That's what I'm saying. You feel me? Like, because I could grow as a person. And I was always, you know, there to try to teach her, like, okay, there's a lot of shit that you just ignore and just start doing shit just to do it. And it fucks you up at the end. And I'm always there to help you and be supportive and shit. But, like, there's got to be a time and a place where you're like, okay, I know I shouldn't do this, so I'm just not going to do this. You get me? And she would get mad at the fact that basically I'd be looking out for her.
That you know more, that you more higher level. That's
all, that's what it, that's all it was. That's why she. That's why she would always say, that's why you think you know more about everybody. I mean, think you know everything about everybody.
I just say what I'm just saying it.
I speak on what I know. Like, exactly. When I tell you about shit about yourself, I'm like, this is what
and
I noticed.
And you be right.
Thank you. I'm like, people be wrong. I'm like, I ain't talking shit. I ain't saying nothing. I'm like, hey, okay, I noticed that you've been doing this and you peeping this, you know, or you building your confidence up this way, or, you know, you starting to do this,
okay,
that.
Hey, she it's really I'm built noticing. My confidence, for real, because I know, since she, when other people tell you about you, it's like, damn, like, that's great, because I know I'm not crazy now. I know I'm not the only one seeing this, because, you know, other people, they won't say nothing. Like, they, I guess, like, they don't see it. And then you're thinking, like, hold on, am I overthinking? So when you have somebody tell you something and that overthinking thought is, like, cleared,
okay,
it's,
man,
like, bad. Like, you more at peace with yourself. That's how I fuck you. You feel me? That's
because I'm like, period. I ain't going to just speak on everything because, you know, that's not my business. That's people's right. lives. But every once in a while, I'm like, okay, you know, a little support, a little, you know, shit
you
that people don't
time.
Do for them, you know?
And sometimes you got to let them grow on their own type shit, let them figure out their
exactly.
shit.
Exactly, I do. And then when they say it out loud, I'm like, yeah, see, I was waiting for that to happen. They be like, huh? And then I speak on the shit that made me notice what
cause you
the
already
journey
know what,
was,
you,
right?
I mean, you already know that they're going to get themselves into this.
Mm-hmm.
So when they
when
do,
I be 10 steps ahead and when I show them the evidence of how I knew, they be mad. Like, how the fuck?
Because
you don't pay attention to yourself. I pay attention to myself and everything else. I'm like, my brain moves a mile a minute, so it's always analyzing everything. Like, people's vibes, energy, what's going on, like, everything. Like, I can look at somebody's eyes and be like, damn, you a drain. You good? Like, It's just people don't, I feel like a lot of people get annoyed when people actually want to be there for them because they're not used to people being there for them. And it
they
makes them
you,
feel
they
like.
They think you're trying to make them feel like a kid or something. Like,
yeah,
you,
or a
like
pity
my
party
parent.
Or, you know, yeah.
Like
or,
that.
Oh, I feel sorry for you. Or, you know, like weird shit.
It's
just,
not like that, man.
Yeah. It really isn't. They be blowing it out of proportion.
For real.
All right, y'all should really get a blend jet. You feel me? This shit really
oh, yeah.
do shit.
Nigga, I was like, hold on. I was like, what the fuck, nigga?
That shit really do shit, you feel me? You throw a little some ice up in that bitch, you feel me? I don't know, some of y'all might drink, you make a little margarita, tequila, I don't know what the fuck, Hennessy, lemonade, slushies, all that shit, you make, yeah. Or for me, I just be drinking slushy water, because, like, you know, stay hydrated. But, yeah, that shit go.
This is like the, what's up, they something like this came out a long time ago, I think the Ninja Bullet? Ninja
yeah,
Bullet.
But that's at the house, this is the bloody jet, this is what you take with you, this is pork.
This hard as fuck, nigga.
Right,
oh,
right,
nigga. That's hard. So you still watch your son?
Oh, yeah.
That's hard as fuck. I look in the car like, what the fuck? That's hard. I'm on my knees. Where'd you get that?
They got some at a few places, but I can send you the link for the ones that are online. Yeah, and I can send you where you can get them, like, in the store, too. But, let me do that shit right now.
She over here did some.
Shit.
I did some things.
I always got something.
I'm mesmerized, for real. I'm like a kid, too. Like, how like that shit.
I always got some type of shit on me. Always got some type of shit on me, bro.
Be finding shit.
No, my mama had bought one. It was like, shit, I can't buy myself one without buying her. Like,
oh, my God.
So, yeah, she got a purple one. I got a green one. Shit, I mean, you know, I just be having shit. You feel me?
Got the mini blended. Anyways, y'all, so that concludes the mukbang type shit. You feel me?
It's nice seeing y'all again.
Yeah, you feel me? We were going and
wear your mask, nigga. Still out here catching corona.
Oh yeah, I got the nigga. Nigga, you feel me? Got this shit right here. You know,
everybody's still catching corona out in this bitch.
Yeah, niggas be dirty and shit. But anyways, I catch y'all when I see y'all. See y'all when I catch y'all.